We are short-staffed, you know.
I'm Rachel from Barlow House. I've come to collect Derek. Could you show him where he is, please?
I know you are. You used to work on the unit, didn't you?
Yeah, that's right.
I remember. He'll be on the ward somewhere. You'll have to find him yourself.
Okay. Merry Christmas.
Yeah. Merry Christmas.
I'm dreaming of a white
Christmas.
Just like the one.
Give me the
in your dreams, you make me.
Right.
Sort
this out.
Where the treetops.
Hey, what's going on?
I want to watch the garden.
One at a time. I want to watch the garden.
It just comes in and it turns out like
okay,
yellow things.
Listen to me. This isn't going to sort anything out this way. Let's do it diplomatically, shall we? Heads or tails?
You're not
having
tails.
Come here.
There you are, Derek. I've been looking all over for you and here you are.
Thank you.
Christmas can't arrive.
Main boy!
Oh, I know it must seem unusual. You're leaving hospital at Christmas time, coming to live in a new home. I can guarantee you're going to love this place.
Oh, I'm sure I will. You know me, I like to meet new people.
You'll soon settle in, Derek. Weather's glorious for this time of year, isn't it?
Mm.
Well, they're all here. Let's get you introduced to them, eh?
New blood.
Hello.
Welcome to the Nut House, mate.
It's not like that, really. They're a good bunch, aren't you? Then we have regular house meetings, don't we, everybody?
Hey, Rachel, how are you fixed for tonight?
I told you, Dougie, you're not my type.
I'm George. Ooh. I'm about to make it big with a record contract. Listen, I won't bother unpacking, mate. There's a few nutters in here. I'd get out while you can. Listen, I'm after somebody who's got a bit of money to put in for a recording session. Would you be into that, mate? What's your name? I'm Young George. That's my stage name.
Well, I'm Derek. Mm. It's nice to meet you, George. Young George. Well, see you all later. Just go and settle in.
Oh, no. Here comes Violet.
Oh, don't
hello.
Worry.
I thought I'd say hello. My name is Violet.
Hello there.
She's been here 10 years.
I'm the longest-serving resident here in Barlow House.
Well, it's nice to meet you, Violet. I'm Derek.
I'm a leftover from when it was first a home for the elderly. And when they tried to kick me out, I took them to court. And I won. That's why I'm here.
Right.
I'm not mentally ill like the rest of them. I've got all my marbles, you know. Are you a visitor or a patient?
Well, I'm sort of... visiting, really.
If you don't mind, Violet, Derek will want to settle in, so we'll see you later.
Don't shout, I'm not deaf. I've got a little complaint for you. We'll go through it tonight, then.
OK, I'll see you later.
We'll see about it later.
OK, Violet.
Don't let me down, will
I
you?
I won't let you down.
Don't let me down,
no,
will
I
you?
No, I won't do.
Don't let me down, will you?
Violet, she won't let you down. I'm looking forward to a nice few little chats with you. I'm just going to settle in, though. All right, see
all
you
right.
later.
Yeah. See you later.
Nice to see you, Violet. Yeah.
All right.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh dear. Must be getting depressed again. Well, this is one depression that's not going to beat us, Derek, because you've got to be strong now. Really strong. So? Come on. then, Derek. Be yourself, and you can be at home anywhere.
You're going.
Sorry, good morning. It's my washing. Is there a member of staff that could take care of it for me, please?
Where do you think you are, the Hilton? Pick that lot up and follow me.
Oh, here we go again, Derek. Here we go again.
Come on. Right, get your washing in there. I take it you can use a washing machine, can't you? And while you're here, get that down yourself. Go on, what are you waiting for?
Just exactly who are you?
I'm Andy, and I'm the nurse here, mate. Now get that down your neck.
Well, can I just inform you, Andy, that I don't do medication? You see, I like to keep my thought processes both clear and for myself. When they made me take the medication on the last ward, it made my speech slurred and made me feel very dopey.
Dopey?
Very. So that's why I don't do medication.
Get that down your neck now. We're the experts and rules are rules. Take it.
Rules are there for the blind obedience of fools and for the guidance of wise men.
Yes, you may. Another muppet.
Your wife's here with your daughter. I'll leave you to it. If you need anything, you'll help yourselves. I'm very, very busy. Sit down. I brought you some fruit, Billy. How are you feeling, love?
Hi, Dad. You look brilliant. Are you all right?
Garden's lovely and house is lovely too. Are you happy here, Billy?
What do you want from me?
Nothing. We just want you to come home. Come home and be a family again. Yeah, come home for Christmas.
Mum!
Look, this is my home. I can't go home. I don't want to go home, do I? I'm better staying here, love, while I'm like this.
I can look after you, Billy. Oh, come home, love. Come home for Christmas, yeah?
Leave me alone. I don't want to go home. I can't go home. I need to be here while I'm healthy. Please don't. Well, I couldn't right. Put you through another breakdown.
No,
I couldn't.
Right,
I love
love.
You both,
right.
But please, you're making it harder for me. Making it harder for yourself.
It's all right, love. It's all right. It's really all right. You'll be all right. You will.
Leave me.
For goodness sake, put yourself together. It's strength he needs, not weakness.
I love you both, but leave it. Leave it.
It's a lovely day, isn't it?
I suppose. I'm Lazarus. Who are you?
Well, I'm Derek. Hmm. Lazarus. Where did you get that name from? It's very biblical.
It was when I was in hospital. All the patients call me Lazarus because I keep coming back from the dead. Or because I look like death warmed up.
Well, it's very nice to meet you, Lazarus. How long have you been a patient here, Lazarus?
3 years. I moved in at Christmas 3 years ago. Mm. It's a nice Christmas present, isn't it?
It's the medication that makes your speech slur, isn't it?
Mm.
You know, the next time you take your medication, Lazarus, will you do me a favour? Don't swallow your tablets. Don't let Andy see you doing it either. I'll guarantee you'll feel much better. You will.
Okay then, Derek.
You mind if I join you?
Look, before you say out, I know I shouldn't be fishing for goldfish. It used to be an hobby of mine as a kid, you know. Didn't like using a net. Caught too many fish. It's not good for the environment, is it? You know what I mean?
Don't worry. You just enjoy yourself. It's not like Christmas, is it? Eh? The weather's glorious.
Some Christmas. I hate Christmas.
So how long have you been here?
If you don't mind, I'd rather be left alone.
Of course. I know what it's like, you know. I'm in exactly the same mood myself. Christmas in a new home with new people. I mean, it's not conducive for the season, is it? You should be at home with the family.
It's not exactly new for me. I've been here nearly 2 months now. I can't go home. This is my home.
You know, sometimes we're guilty of taking on too much work. We forget that our brains need to rest just like our bodies do.
I used to be an estate agent. Had a very, very successful little business. Well, sure, all of a sudden it was gone and I just walked away from it all. But I didn't recognise my own wife or my own daughter. That was the hard part. Of course, I know who they are now, obviously, because I'm on the mend. I must have really, really let them down.
He who punishes himself for too long also punishes his loved ones too. Anyway, I'll leave you with your thoughts. But it's Billy, isn't it?
They call me Quiet Billy, yeah. I don't know why. I haven't shut up since you spoke to me.
Your name, I saw it in the medical notes. Mine's Terry.
How long have you been here, Terry?
32 minutes.
No, I mean in Barlow House.
2 years, 3 months, 1 day.
Do you need any help, right?
No. I can't trust anybody else. It's just something I have to do. I've just got to check a few things, make sure everything's in the right place.
Well, I'll leave you to get on, but if you need any help, you just give me a shout.
All right. You think I'm mad, don't you? I'm not. I just have these little rituals I have to do. Can't help it. Started with saluting magpies. Morning, Mr. Magpie. You know, things like that. Then I found myself having to go back into the house once or twice, you know, just to make sure I'd turned all the lights off. Make sure I'd locked all the doors once or twice. Double check, I'd locked the car, things like that. Do you walk under ladders?
No.
I do. So I'm not that mad, am I?
You know what I think, Terry? I think what the mind conceives, the mind must also control.
What the mind conceives, the mind must also control.
Bernard?
Mm.
Remember when we were in Spain and we said we'd like to get a villa out there to live in?
Yes, we do.
Well, I think we should retire and buy one. this year?
Yes, my love.
You're not really bothered, are you?
Of course I'm bothered, my darling Cleo. But where are we going to get the capital from?
This place, where else?
I can't sell it just like that. What about the residents? They'll have to be rehoused. Also, I have to get permission from the trustees, if you remember.
What do you mean, trustees?
Oh, it was before we met, before we got married. It was a condition of buying the property. Yes, I own the house, but there's a clause in the purchase agreement. It was set up as a rehabilitation for mental patients, care in the community. You know all this, darling. I can't sell it just like that. I have to seek permission from the trustees first.
So what's the problem? Why can't we start the ball rolling now?
All right. I'll get the ball rolling tomorrow. But what are we going to live on?
We've got a good pension. And don't forget our savings from this place.
Oh, don't say that in here.
Oh, don't worry, Mr. Cautious. It's been nearly 10 years and no one's found out.
Oh, I trust you, my darling Cleo. Behind every successful man, there's a brilliant woman. Oh, good night, my love.
Good night, darling.
Good night, my angel.
I can hardly believe that Christmas was only 12 weeks away. Hey, and you've been here nearly a year now.
You know, I can't believe the time's just passing.
Suburban land, perhaps fit 6 private dwellings. First impression, Sandra, yes, we'll go for this one. Organise a memo deal for Bernard Baron of Barlow House.
Mr. Lee. Hi, Mr. Baron. Nice to meet you. Oh, what a lovely car.
He's an estate agent, Tim.
Really? Wow, could you tell?
25 years in the business. I can smell them a bloody mile away. He used to be one, remember?
Oh, don't start lecturing me again, Dougie. I'm not in the mood.
You all right, Nigel?
Don't seem your usual upbeat self.
Fine. Just tired.
Tired?
You haven't done a day's work in 5 years.
Yeah, you're right. I haven't.
It's because you're a sloth. You know, I wouldn't be surprised if you had a member of staff to feed you. Or Terry there to be your manservant.
What's a sloth?
A sloth is what he is.
It's a sloth, actually.
Shut it, Bazza. Shouldn't be picking on him. He's missing his daughter.
I didn't know he had a family.
Yeah, he's got a daughter on the Devon coast somewhere. It's her birthday today and he's not seen her since he got ill.
He's been ill on and off for the last 5 years. Do you reckon he spent more time in a psychiatric unit than the rest of us put together?
No more than me, actually.
His daughter's name is Debbie, short for Deborah. She's 26 today. Happy birthday, Debbie. Born in Manchester, moved away. Couldn't cope with a broken down family. Couldn't cope with a broken down dad. Moved away. I've got it all here somewhere. I just can't seem to find it.
It's all right, Terry. You can leave it for now. Thanks for that.
Don't worry, Terry. You're all right.
Hey, I tell you what. Why don't we organise a weekend away somewhere? Hey, what about that minibus?
Yeah, it never gets bloody used.
That's a shame, isn't it? Lazarus, your turn for tea juices.
Right, I'm coming.
Well, come on, I shouldn't be coming out here getting you.
Oh, who's rattled your cage?
Come on, Bernard's got someone in his office.
Sloth, actually.
Excuse me, Teddy.
There's not much in it for me, really. I could get about 4 properties on the side, but there's no profit for me at all.
Oh, come off it. You could get 8 houses on this land once the house has been demolished.
No. You see, there's planning permission as well. Now, Bernard, I could get 3 or 4 properties. That's all, really.
So, how much are you asking for it?
Oh, just a moment, just leave it there.
Is it still going for 200,000?
What, yes.
Don't mind me, I'm a bit mental, a bit thick.
No! God damn it! Look, just leave it, Lazarus!
Now listen, I'm prepared to make you an offer, right? 160,000.
Oh, I was thinking more in the region of 190.
170.
Look, go! Now, please!
Sorry.
I really need to discuss this with Cleo, my wife.
Sure, of course, no problem. But I must warn you, I am seeing three more land properties this afternoon. I will be buying one for sure.
Well, I really need much more than that. It's for my retirement. I need to survive, and I need to buy a new house for my old age. I'm sure you realise.
170.
180, surely.
All right, I'll tell you what. My final offer, 175,000. I'll give you, say, till Christmas to complete, OK? That should give me enough time to do all the paperwork and also for you to make the relative arrangements to get rid of your friends.
My friend? Oh, the residents, oh, yes. I'll have to step up a gear with the trustees. Yes. Okay, we agree, £175,000. But you have to agree to give me until the first week in January to get everyone moved out. I mean, it would be deemed inappropriate if I moved them out over Christmas.
Done, deal. Okay, first week in January, earth movers move in. Okay, give the lawyers enough time to do the paperwork.
Splendid. I'll just give Cleo, my wife, a call to tell her the good news. She's out Christmas shopping, even though it's October. She loves spending money.
Sandra, make that eight, please. Eight.
Eight?
Yeah, eight. For dinner tonight. We're having a dinner party.
Oh. Cornelius, out.
Hi, Nigel. Thanks, Nigel. You can go now.
Well, you haven't written it down, Rachel. You're supposed to update the records so you know that I've taken my medication. You know, since you've qualified as a social worker and a nurse, I think it's overloaded you a bit. It's gone to your head. It's just an observation, mind.
Well, thank you for that, Dr. Nigel. I'll be putting it in my notes in a minute. Now, as far as becoming a resident social worker as well as a nurse going to my head is concerned, I can assure you it hasn't. Now, if I was earning an extra £20,000 a year, maybe. Thank you, Nigel.
Bye-bye, Nigel.
Muppet.
Got any plans after work tonight, Andy?
No, nothing special.
How's Susan and the kids, OK?
Fine.
What's on the menu then tonight? Homemade courier takeout.
Look, Rachel, can you just leave it, please? I don't want to talk about this.
He's got a few problems at home, Rachel. I wouldn't press him on that one.
Do you mind, Mr. Perfect Nigel? Out! Look, I'm sorry about that, Rachel.
It's OK.
Susan's left me.
Took the kids.
She's left me last week.
Oh, hey,
Derek. I was thinking of taking some of the residents out for a day trip to the seaside in the minibus. Can I book it, please?
That's a lovely idea, Derek.
Must be joking. There's no way that's going to come off.
Why is that, then? There's been a minibus on that driveway never used since I got here.
No money, no insurance and no driver.
I'll drive and I'll pay you in phone for an insurance cover. Not a problem.
Leave it with me, Derek. I'll sort something out.
Thank you, Rachel. That'll be wonderful. And thank you, Andy, for your bottomless pit of wonderful enthusiasm and forward thinking. Perhaps you should join the prison service. They have a nice salary and you get a uniform. See ya.
There's no way that's going to happen while I'm here, right?
We'll see about that, shall we?
Now then, it's not like you to be so glum, so come on, tell me about it. Oh, come on.
The Barons selling this place off by Christmas and we've all got to move out in January.
Who's told you that?
You know that flash geezer that was here this morning?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I heard him and Baron talking. They're buying it to knock it down and build houses.
What, not this town? This place?
No, this is my home. I've got nowhere else to go.
Oh, we'll see about that, shall we? The opportunity of a lifetime must be taken within the lifetime of the opportunity. The opportunity of a lifetime must be taken within the lifetime of the opportunity. Have you told anybody?
No.
Right, go and get the others. Don't say anything to anyone yet. Go and get the others and meet me back here in 10 minutes. Now go on, quick. Opportunity of a lifetime. Let's take within the lifetime of the opportunity. Come on. James! James, it's Derek! Yeah, I'm very well. Listen, James, I can't talk for very long. James, just listen, please. I need you to do a couple of jobs for me.
I've transferred the money out of the account. All we have to do is work out what to spend it on. And we've got enough now for the villa and with the sale of this place, a nice little pension fund.
Yes, well, I'd rather not talk about that in here, Cleo.
Oh, what's there to worry about? No one's listening, and even if there were, they're too thick to know what we're talking about.
Yes, but regardless of that, embezzlement is a serious crime. We could get put in prison.
Oh, stop worrying. We're not going to get found out. We're far too clever for that. In any case, we deserve the money after 10 years of working in this house. All we've done is take a small percentage for giving these people a home.
So, how much have we got, then?
£128,000. It's a small amount for putting up with these... idiots.
I've decided to call this house meeting myself, seeing as the water and the staff don't seem to be very productive. Now, I need to know from each and every one of you what the most important thing is to you right now. Bazza, we'll start with you. What's important to you right now?
My sanity. And getting rid of these occasional pains in my head. Yeah, how's that for a nutter, eh? Succinct or what?
And what about home, Bazza? Is home important to you?
Well, this is my home. I lost my house when I couldn't pay the mortgage. And for those of you who don't know, I had a bang on my head and I completely lost my marbles. Yeah, how about that, eh? A complete life story in just 15 seconds.
I like that. It was about 15 seconds at all. Well done, Bazza.
And you, Terry? What's important to you, Terry?
Where my next meal's coming from.
And where is your next meal coming from?
From the kitchen at 5:20, which gives me 10 minutes to eat it while watching Tom and Jerry from 5:20 to 5:30 on BBC Two.
Thank you, Terry. And you, Nigel? What would you like out of life right now?
Not arguing with him. No, seeing me daughter again. She's in Devon, a little place called Salcombe by the Sea where the sun shines all day. She's called Debbie, and I love her very much. We lost touch because she couldn't stand the pain of a broken family.
My turn.
Right, okay.
I want to see the sea. I want to see Nigel see his daughter again.
Thank you, Debbie. I fancy seeing the bands, you know, like down south. See what the music scene's like down there. Maybe even sing with a few of them, you know.
I'd usually say that I want a little house of my own. You know, like this one, if I could decorate it and do it up a bit, but right now I'd like to see Nigel with his daughter, Debbie.
Oh.
There we go.
for you, Lazarus?
My own place to live. Some security. I feel a lot happier now. I think I've done my time.
Thank you. And you, Billy?
Well, I'm angry inside, but I want to fight. I'm sick and tired of people walking all over me, you know. I was an estate agent and a property developer, and well, I nearly lost the most important thing in the world to me, my family, by working too hard. And I'm angry and I want to fight, but I want to fight myself, you know. You just imagine me in a boxing ring, fighting myself, trying to knock daylight out of myself.
Thank you, Billy. Okay. I've made my mind up. We're going on a short holiday to Salcombe so that Nigel can see his daughter.
Oh, no!
Now, I need you all to pack a small suitcase, but don't let Rachel or Angry Henry see you do it. Very important. Bring whatever money you can, and I'll make a plan as we go along.
Yes!
Hang on, how are you going to do that? How are you going to get there?
We're going in the minibus, Billy. Billy, I know you want to see the sea, my friend, but I need you to stay here to do a job for me.
Yeah?
Right?
Yeah?
Trust me. Okay. Now, there's something else I haven't told you. This house, our home, is to be sold at Christmas.
What?
Christmas? Yeah. Now, I'm prepared to fight for this, and I want to know if you're up for a fight.
Yes.
Are we up for a fight?
Yes!
Are we sick and tired of being thought of as social outcasts?
Yes! Yes.
Right! Put your trust in me. I won't let you down, I promise.
I've got the road atlas, so I know exactly where we're going and how long it'll take us to get there.
Well done, Nigel.
Where are we going?
Going on holiday, Dougie, come on.
What for?
Oh, I've told you once now, come on, get in the van.
Who am I
standing
next to?
You're
going to
sit next to me and then I'm sitting next to yours, now get in.
Who's driving?
It doesn't matter now, get in the van.
Hey, I'm going to see some bands when I get down there.
There are
any
bands in Devon.
Yeah, it's London, isn't it?
It's London
bands. Shall I burn the house down?
Shut it,
Papa! Right. 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 Right.
Now then, page 8. Right. Here we are. Now, there, we're going for there.
Rachel, come here, quick. Leave this. I've got a degree and I'm chasing these muppets. You lot, back in the house!
So, M5...
Hey, what should you pay that, Derek? You're not even insured.
Oh, yes, I am.
Nigel, out. You should know better than this.
What do we do, Derek?
We're going on holiday, Andy. And you're very welcome to join us if you like.
You must be joking. You lot, out!
What's up,
Andy? Shit, I'm going to lawyer out of here now. Move! Get out.
Andy, this is your last chance. You either come with us or you get out.
Get it out.
6 minutes to dinner.
Oh, you! Sit down! You bully boy, you can shoot your face. Fancy picking on Terry. Didn't tell me to get out, did you?
I take it you're coming with us, then. Close the doors and tie him up.
You can't do that, will you? Get
him! Yeah. Oh, yes, we can.
Get him! Oh, get him! Get...
Yes.
Okay, now you're up.
We've referenced F2.
We're off in an Oscar. The 60s offers are off. We don't know where we are.
We're off
in an Oscar.
In the morning with our handful of dreams, and we sensed that this day was like no other we'd seen. Like a ship in still waters on a listless sea.
Did you have to bring the dog?
Shut it, Baron.
Do you mind not shouting? Of course I'm bringing the dog. You don't think I'm leaving him with the dreadful Baron, do you? Oh, Andy.
Yeah.
We're going to have to use your credit card, but I'll pay you back as soon as we can. What's he doing?
Hey, that'll do nice. Look at that, Derek.
Thank you, my friends. You know the old saying? Your credit will be due to you when your credentials become creditable. Come on, Nigel.
Right, orderly line. Let's pull forward, Sandy.
Use that credit card, you just remember the security I've left mine behind.
I'm hungry.
That's right. Teddy. Unsign me, lad. Come on, that's it. Teddy. Good lad, come on. Teddy. Teddy. Excuse me, can one of you untie me, please?
Look after Andy.
Hey!
You've had 3 weeks today. One of them...
Derek, please, I'm down at the toilet.
Sarah, will you untie Andy for me, please?
Thank you.
Untie it for me.
Quickly, Sarah, I mean, I can hear it.
Terry! Oi, come here.
I'm dying.
Derek, just come here a minute. Listen, I'm the only voice you can hear.
I'm away, you two.
Just go and look at the view, please, Terry. Thank you.
Lovely here, Derek.
Well, I showed you it'd be nice, didn't I? Have a look.
Oh, I'm a little bit nervous about meeting Debbie now, Derek.
I'm not even sure whether we're going to be able to find her.
Of course we will, Nigel. But tonight we'll have a little rest and then a party. After all, we are on holiday at the seaside, you know.
I've not seen the sea for such a long time. Reminds me of the Mediterranean here.
Right, I'm going to get a train. Can we credit card back, please?
Right. Thank you. Oh, you better use my phone and tell your wife you're going to be late.
That's a bit of a touchy subject at the moment. Trial separation.
Where are you all going to sleep?
Well, I thought we might get a nice little hotel somewhere. Maybe a B&B. Somewhere nice and comfortable, eh?
Right, listen, I'll stay for one night. I suppose you'll have to use this again, won't you?
Well, I did say I'd pay you back. I will.
I know you will. Right, who's for another drink, then?
No.
Might as well make the most of it, eh?
My head's killing me.
Why? You all right? Is it your injury? Do you want a doctor?
No, it's hangover.
Oh, you fool. You had me going then.
Right, Derek.
I'm all right, Andy. How are you?
All right.
He's got angled. Half mouth batter. Anyway, you know what they say? Those who have good health are rich but do not know it. So are we to drop you at the train station then?
Well, how long are you staying?
Oh, just a few days, so that Nigel can see his daughter.
Well, it is okay with everybody. I'd like to stay if you don't mind.
You'll be very welcome, Andy. More than welcome. Just relax and chill.
Thanks.
Besides, diplomacy is the art of tranquil fishing in troubled waters, my friend.
Right, I'll have to think about that, Derek. I'll go to the bar, eh? Thanks again.
Okay. Come on, Sandy.
Here we go. I'm sure we are. I'll just have a bit of
We have been up here.
This has been a big mistake. We'll never ever find her. We should have stayed in Manchester.
Have a bit of faith, Nigel. We will find her.
That's supposed to be lucky, isn't it?
Fortune comes to those that smile. That endure shall not be overcome. You wait here a moment. I'll be back in a minute.
Yeah, but
I... Faith, Nigel, please. Trust me. There you are, my friend.
What's this?
I got it off the voters list.
Debbie's address?
Absolutely. Come on.
What?
Quayside, down there, on that
road. What are we doing here, Derek?
Nigel, I'm preparing you. Because you want to see your daughter, don't you?
Yes, of course I do. I think I'm ready.
So what are you going to say to her?
I'm going to tell her that I miss her. And I love her very much.
Then I think you're ready.
Yeah.
Right. Now, have you got any money to pay this bill?
No.
Neither have I, so on the count of three, when I shout three, we get up and we run.
Now, don't panic.
Just take your time. Duck around. Take your time. Sip your tea. Control. One, two, three, go.
The wretch is coming!
Some and sand can do for you, Bazza.
I've got a ball!
You know, I really like your sandcastle.
Dear.
Yeah. Can I help you build it?
It's going to be a masterpiece. It's going to be a great building. You can if you want.
Thanks.
What I'm going to do, I'm going to put another one there and some stone.
Excuse me.
Sorry. That's my Teddy.
Listen, Teddy, where's Nigel and Derek gone?
I think it's supposed to be a secret.
Listen, I need to know because we're going to go shortly.
They're going to find Nigel's daughter, Debbie.
Thanks, Terry.
Right, you lot, how about a barbecue tonight?
Yeah.
Are you going to pay for that, Andy?
I've paid for everything else so far, haven't I?
Oh, yeah, cool.
I'll end up liking you, mate.
Terry, say try to your friend we're going.
I know it's unusual living on a boat, but I love it. It used to be Eddie's, so I don't have to pay anything to anyone. He owned it, you see.
Do you think he'll ever come back and claim it?
No, don't need it. It's a nice bloke, really. The last I heard, he moved to Saudi and shacked up with a nurse.
To think I've never ever seen little Jenny. I can't believe I've got such a beautiful granddaughter. She's a little marvel.
You're looking great, Dad. Is everything back to normal? Because it looks like it.
Oh, feeling great. Been feeling good for a while, actually. Fingers crossed. Certainly don't feel depressed, and I don't do those disappearing acts anymore either. We must never, ever lose touch again. Now, what do you think, eh? About coming up to Manchester with me, and Jenny, of course.
It's early days yet, Dad. I've got things to sort out in my life down here. I mean, Jenny's settled here. Anyway, we're going to have to see how it goes, yeah?
I understand. 100%. I'm not sure I could have done that a few years ago, though, love. Debbie, if there's ever anything I can do for you, I've still got capital tied up in shares and so on. That could help a bit.
I'll tell you what I need. I need a damn good night out with you tonight. I can get a sitter for Jenny. I'd love to meet some of your friends. I'd like to thank Derek too, well, seeing as though it was his idea to bring you to see me.
This has been a dream come true for me, Debbie. I'd like that. I'd like that a lot.
Hiya, love. I'm William Forshaw, and I'm here to see you. Mr. David Lee. Now, before you say anything, no, I haven't got an appointment, but I have got a prime site for him, and I know he'll be interested because it's going for the right price, you know. So, go on, ask him, and I'll bet you the five that he sees me. Hey, he'll thank you for this later on. Hey, he might even get you a blue pizza pouch.
Just a moment. Hi, yeah, we've got a surprise visitor. Right, okay then. Go through now.
Oh, you know me a five, what did I tell you? Thanks, love.
Ah, nice to meet you. Forshaw?
Billy. That's what my mates would call me if I had any. Billy, no mates.
So, what can we do for each other? I don't normally see people without an appointment unless...
Unless there's a financial interest in it for you, which is quite right. So, let's cut to the chase, shall we, David? I've got several large niches of land and I'm thinking of offloading some, you know. It's all ideally situated, it's ripe for building on and... well, you see, I made all my money in this game years ago by getting stuck in and getting my hands dirty. How did you make yours, David?
So I don't know where you're coming from. What makes you think I want to buy some land? I may not be in the market to purchase at the moment.
Of course you are. We all are of the prices right now. Look, I'm a pretty straight-talking guy, aren't I? And I've got land for sale at a knock-down price. You've got the money, you've got the contact for developing and for planning permission. And the truth is, I'm about to retire and I just need to get rid of some of it.
I don't know what you want or, indeed, what it is. What are you selling?
Look, I want a quick sale. I know how quickly I can deal with it. What I want to know is how quickly can you deal with it? Take Barlow House, eh? When are you going to exchange contracts? How soon do you envisage having the demolition men move in?
Oh, well, I mean, I sign and exchange contracts and complete within the same day, which means in 2 days. I think you'll agree that is pretty quick. But there seems to be a technicality with this particular case because I can't take ownership of the property until the 24th of December. That means I can't get the earth movers in until January. You see, There are trustees with the property, you see. Anyway, I don't care. I'm playing golf in Tenerife. But legally, I will have ownership of the land and the house by then. So, as I can appreciate you're impressed at how quick I can work, what are you trying to sell?
So you complete the business in 2 days, but you don't take possession till the 24th of December. Well, that's Christmas Eve. I mean, you can't be throwing people out of a home on Christmas Eve.
No. As I said, not until January, because I'm playing golf. Look, what are you trying to achieve?
I'll tell you what, Dave.
David.
Well, I'll tell you what I'll do, David. When I'm ready to move on this deal, I'll get my people to have a talk with your people, and I'll tell you something else, David. I used to be like you. I used to be exactly like you. And if you don't watch exactly where you're going, you're going to come in for a very, very nasty shock. There's a sample of my land. Have a look at it in there. Let me know what you think. Cheerio.
David.
Look, I'm telling you, David Lee is signing the contract in 2 days.
I'm coming back tomorrow anyway.
Have you got a plan, or are you bloody bonkers?
No, I'm not bonkers, Billy, but you're going to have to trust me on this. Everybody's going to have faith in me over the next few weeks. It's better to live one day as a lion than 100 years as a sheep.
I haven't got any idea what you're on about, Derek. What does it bloody mean?
Look, Billy, what I'm saying is be brave. I know what I'm doing, Billy, so let me handle this, OK? Now, I'll see you tomorrow, so stop questioning me. Let me get on with it. I've got to go, Billy. See ya. See you tomorrow. Now, we'll have to go back to Manchester in the morning.
But surely I can stay here with my Debbie.
We've been through this, Dad.
Well, I could get a job. I'd cash me shares in.
You never learn by talking. The desire to get things done quickly prevents their being done thoroughly.
So, does this mean we're going home tomorrow then, or what?
Look, I have a plan, but I need your trust and your support. I need you to trust and support me over the next few weeks, right? Now, can I count on you to do this? Yeah. Good. Can I count on you, Andy?
Well, yeah, within reason. I mean, come this far, but not to lose now, have I?
That's the spirit, Andy. That's the spirit. Well, that's it then. We have a battle to win, and we're going to win it.
Derek, can I just use your phone a minute? I want to give Rachel a ring. No, let her know that we're coming back and where we are.
Such a thing as knocking, you know.
Oh, I didn't hear you knocking on my door to tell me you were selling Barlow House. You let me carry on housing people. Have you any idea what it's like to house people, let them settle, and then uproot them and put them through the same trauma all over again? You wouldn't have a damn clue about that, would you?
It is my husband and I who are running a business here. And it is my husband and I who have decided to sell up and retire. You work for the health service, and you work in the property I own.
Maybe. But there's such a thing as giving us a decent amount of time to work on this. You can't just say, that's it, everybody, in 9 or 10 weeks you're out. Oh, and I suppose you realise that's Christmas time.
Quite finished.
It's just a business to you, isn't it?
Yes.
I just hope that one day you'll regret the way you've treated these people. You just can't do this.
Mm-hmm. Why don't you put that notebook away, eh, and stop being such a compulsive? Yeah, that's what you are. You're a compulsive obsessive.
Why don't you tell me something I don't already know?
I used to be an aircraft engineer, me.
You what?
When hundreds and hundreds of people's lives depend on you to check and double-check for safety reasons, and you wake up screaming in the middle of the night, sweating, thinking to yourself, did I check that engine properly? Am I sure that I've not caused some fatal disaster? Is an aircraft going to crash because of my incompetence? you check and check again, and again, and again. Everybody says, oh, Teddy's happy, Teddy's happy, writing his little notes in his book, keeping a record of everything. I am happy, because it gets me through Bazza. But as far as I can see, you're the one who's got a problem. You're too loud, Bazza. You're too loud, and you've got to be always the centre of attention.
Why don't you write it down, then, in case you forget?
Come on, mate.
Look, we've all got our problems, right? But I do understand what you're saying, mind. Pick that up. Go on, pick it up.
I'm not too sure about this, Sarah. What do you really think? Are you really sure?
Absolutely positive. It's going to be a brand new start for us. If we don't like it, we can always go back home. Stop worrying. What you need is a spot of lavender oil on your pillow and a nice cup of dandelion tea.
What?
Look around. Life's not that bad.
You know, I just can't believe it. I've only just found you and I'm already saying goodbye. Debbie, you are going to be okay.
Of course I am, Dad. It's only going to be for a little while. Anyway, you just concentrate about getting better and we'll be back together soon. I promise. Come here. Ghost, come on.
Come on.
Good thinking, Debbie.
Be yourself. And you'll be at home anyway.
You will be happy, Nigel. You haven't walked through life without leaving evidence of your passage this time.
Now, I wish you all the success in the world, and I'm sure that Debbie's kindness and that you stay with her will give you a good start. But here's my mobile phone number. If you ever need me, contact me, won't you?
Thanks, Derek.
Thank you, Debbie. God bless you both.
Thank you.
And good luck. See you.
Bye, Derek.
Encouraging mutiny.
Don't let yourself remember. Has my wife called while I was awake?
You're cutting it fine, you know. You're going to throw a spanner in the works. Hope you've got something up your sleeve, because I'm beginning to build me hopes up here.
What do you mean, Billy?
What do I mean? I mean, what's happening? What have you got planned?
I'm going to buy this house.
Oh, well, it was good while it lasted. And I'll tell you something, Derek, lad. You really had me fooled, you know. I really felt like a private detective when I was in that Dave Lee's office. Suddenly all my confidence come back, didn't it? Hey, you should have seen the smarmy get. I mean, who does he think he is, eh? I said to him, hey, I said, I used to be like you, and I said it right up to his smug little bloody face. I didn't know what to think when you first said to me, go and see him and see if you can dig out any information. But I tell you what, it was good. No, it was bloody marvellous.
Can I speak to Mr. Bernard Bannon, please? It's an urgent business call.
Well, I'm afraid the house is sold. How can I help?
Yes, I know the house is sold, but it's only sold subject to contract, I believe. How much for, may I ask?
Well, seeing that you ask, £175,000. But as you say, it's sold subject to contract.
Well, I'm a businessman, so I'll come straight to the point here. I'll pay you an extra £20,000
and I can complete the deal at any time?
Well, the extra money would come in handy. Just one moment.
Cleo, there's someone on the phone offering an extra £20,000 for the house.
Oh, hello. This is Cleo Baron here, joint owner of the property. You see, you're willing to offer us an extra £20,000 for the house?
Yes, and I can complete the deal at any time. I have the cash waiting as we speak.
Oh, well, as you know, we already have a definite buyer, and part of the deal is to go ahead tomorrow. We sign an exchange at the same time, too. We haven't met, have we? What did you say your name was?
My name is Mr. Thomas, but let me take away any doubts that you may have. Yes, I can arrange for my lawyer to call in with the papers tomorrow. It's very simple, really, isn't it? It's a case of first come, first served. My lawyer is called Mr. James Bentley.
Oh, well, I suppose we can live with that. We've nothing to lose and 20,000 to gain. But I have to warn you, our purchaser is doing the same deal at noon tomorrow.
So am I to take it that we have a deal?
Yes. Agreed.
Wonderful. Nice doing business with you. Goodbye.
I can't understand you, Derek. You're either a fantastic bloody liar or you are the guardian angel. And, well, I know which one I want you to be.
Billy, do you know why I became ill and ended up on a psychiatric unit?
No, I've never asked. I wouldn't ask anybody. It's private and personal, isn't it?
Well, I used to spend all of my time working to amass hoards of money. I was a writer. I came to England when I was 15, you see. I couldn't speak any of the language. So I got this job selling fruit and vegetables, and I was learning the language very quickly by listening to these phrases that people used to say. Things like, looks like rain again, and hidey high, and you don't get many of those in a pound, love. You know the phrases. And then I learned to write, and I used to write down these phrases that people used to say. So I started to write original ones. And then I earned a living as a writer. I used to write these philosophical phrases for books and birthday cards. I made a lot of money.
Well, have you got a few quid stashed away, like?
Do you know why I ended up being sectioned? Because I set fire to a suitcase in the centre of town. The case had £10,000 in it. People were fighting to stop the money getting burnt, but it did. I've been to buy this car. Buy the car with cash. I'd ordered a blue one, they got me a red one. Well, I was working so hard, Billy, that little thing was so important to me, I wanted a blue car. Well, I just had enough, hadn't I? I flipped. So I just burnt all the money.
Bloody hell, Derek, you must have been ill.
But do you know what my biggest regret was, Billy? The biggest regret?
Can I have three guesses? Burning the money?
Not burning all of the money.
Well, actually, that wasn't one of my guesses, was it?
I'm very rich with life. Very rich with life. Judge a man by his questions, not by his answers. The art of living, my friend, is to want less and experience more. I can remember them all now.
To tell you the truth, I haven't got a clue what you're on about, but it sounds pretty good.
I knew it. You're Jesus Christ and you've come back to save us.
Derek, Leonard's a tenner and I'll pay you back when I get me gyro.
Oh, you're a cool customer, you. Burning 10,000 quid?
Oi! Shut it, the pair of you.
Exactly. Empty vessels make the loudest sound. Judge a man by his questions, not by his answers, eh, Derek? The desire to do things quickly can prevent things being done thoroughly. Be happy in yourself and you'll be happy anywhere. Don't walk through life without leaving evidence of one's passage.
Well done, Terry. Well done. All right, you lot, come here. I'm going to need some of that help I mentioned, Paul, in Salcombe.
Right.
Okay.
How are you? Welcome back, Derek. If Andy can get you now, a cup of pot of tea or anything.
Fine.
Where did you just spring from, you little leprechaun? Dublin, Ireland.
Have you been listening, Pat?
Ah, come on now, it's not hard to be hearing you lot. Derek, I didn't mean any harm. You need him along. Maybe I can help. Only if you want it, mind.
I hear and see things. A lot goes on in this place, I can tell you.
You've got to remember, I've been the caretaker here since this place started. And that's 10 years ago now, mind.
I can tell you loads of things that go on in here. Thieving.
That Bernard Baden and his fancy woman, Cleo. They've been robbing you blind for years, the lot of you.
Okay. Cleo's his wife. Go on, what do you mean?
Well, the money they get from the benefits agency and the social services for looking after you. Mm-hmm. They make a handsome profit out of that, I can tell you. Sure, they're feeding you smoke.
Fool, yes. Oh, you
say that again.
Don't take us on day trips or anything.
Nothing, no.
Never go anywhere.
Never been anywhere.
They pocket the money for all of that. So we'll just catch yourselves up.
Pat! We're going out. You and Andy are in charge.
Pat, make sure Billy keeps the noise down. Make sure she goes down early as well.
Hiya, Mr. Baron. Can I come with you? I've been dying to get away from these weirdos.
I'd rather eat razor blades.
Mm. Have a nice day.
Pat, have you got the keys to the office?
I certainly have.
What are we looking for, Derek?
Greedy people like to see the money. They like to look at their accounts and figures. It could be on that computer, you take my word for it.
Well, they're the house accounts.
Right.
Income and expenditure, reference social services. There's bank movements. Baroness. There's all sorts of stuff, really.
You're very good on this computer, aren't you? All these accounts and numbers and things.
Well, it's part of what I used to do, it's basics, really. Now, this Baroness file sounds interesting. Shall we have a look? You know, about these thieving little tow rags have been ripping us off for years.
I've got to tell you that. They've had 20 lessons here over the last 10 years. Do you know, it's been very obvious to me that the money they get, they don't spend on us properly.
But it's going to take more than that, Pat, you see.
Pat, you said there have been 20 people living here over the last 10 years, yeah?
That's right, love, 20 residents. Did some of them come and go, but 20 on average, yeah?
Well, you see this column here, yeah? That's residents. Sometimes there's 25, sometimes 28. It looks like they're claiming for more people than actually live here. How could they get away with that? Surely social services do checkups and things.
Oh, it's dead easy. You can make false claims and false statements on a computer when you've got no app.
I could have told you that. Every time there's inspection by the authorities, I've got to make up extra beds. Now I've done that at least 10 times in the last 10 years.
Yeah.
They think I'm tick, just a caretaker from Ireland.
Make copies of my little Erin Brockovich on paper and on disk of everything.
That name on there. McDonough, what's he doing on there?
Well, it looks like they're claiming for him. But we can't live here. I've never heard of him, and I've been here for years.
Claiming for him? The man's been dead 6 years. He topped himself in his room. Oh, mother of God, that's him I claim for poor little Mickey, Eddie.
Who's that?
Oh, no, it's David Lee.
Oh, no, if he sees me, he'll recognise me.
Right.
Forget we're snooking.
Don't panic. Lazarus, I want you to do something for me.
What?
Come on.
Ah, Mr. Lee. You're very welcome. We weren't quite expecting you, but come this way, sir. Oh, I'm Derek, by the way. I help run this place.
Oh, yes.
Would you like a cup of tea?
Lovely.
Could we have tea for two, please?
Tell you what, if I get caught doing this, I'll never work again. In fact, I'll be the one sectioned and sent to jail.
Come on, shut it. Get on with it. Andy? Are you sure that's going to be enough to knock him out?
Excuse me, who's got the degree here?
Well, it's not me, is it?
Exactly. Him out for about 3 hours, this. 3 years training I've had. Come on.
What are you doing, Andy?
Can I have a drop of that tea? You know how I love my tea. And why hasn't someone brought a cup to me before this, while I've been waiting, and a lovely chocolate biscuit? You know I was helping you not so very long ago. Now it's time that you were helping me by making me a lovely cup of tea.
OK, Violet, I'll bring you a nice cup of tea to your room, eh?
Yes, okay. You do that.
And you can have a nice little nap after.
You know perfectly well I don't sleep during the day. And I only have 2 hours at night.
Of course you do, Violet.
One of those rare ones with the big eyes and the big legs. We don't normally see them this time of the year. You see, the thing is, everybody's afraid of spiders. But they're just trying to survive like everybody else.
Right, get him!
Wait for it.
You got him?
He chomps away. Mission accomplished. Nice one, Billy.
Ah, James. Right on time as usual.
Good day to you, Derek, sir.
I trust you're well in your new abode.
Very well, thank you, James. How's your family?
Can't complain, sir. I have everything here, sir. I took the liberty of withdrawing cash for the transaction. It's all right, you can carry on. This is my friend, Billy.
How do you know?
I took the liberty because I knew you wanted this deal to go through. Mm-hmm. Now, there's no way that a banker's drop will be cleared in time. I know you well enough now to make sure that a deal happens on time.
This is like a scene from Arthur.
Yeah. Do you wish to see the paper, sir?
No, I trust your judgment, James. More importantly, are you up for it?
Oh, yes, yes, of course, yes. I always wanted to be an actor. This would be like giving a live performance.
This is changing by the second. What have you got up your sleeve, Derek?
Billy, take Mr. Bentley to see Mr. Ballard. Mr. Bentley is Derek Leonard's solicitor. I'm Derek Leonard.
Yes, I know. This way, please.
Mr. Leonard, aren't you representing David Lee?
He's been detained, I believe. I have the money in cash. I know it's unusual, but I thought it best to bring cash, given the fact that I have all the paperwork here. So it's a simple exchange of contracts and completion at the same time.
Just a moment. Cleo, my love, would you step in here for a moment? This is Mr. Bentley. He's David Lee's solicitor. He's brought the contracts for us to sign for the sale when we've looked them over.
Oh, no. I'm not David Lee's solicitor. I'm Derek Leonard's solicitor. Same initials, though.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. We're waiting for Mr. Lee to come. He said he was coming today at 1 o'clock. I'm sure you can understand that.
Well, I have everything here, the contracts, the money, everything. Well, do we have a deal?
So there's £195,000 in there?
No, there's £175,000 here, the asking price.
I spoke to a Mr. Whatever His Name Is on the phone, and he said he was going to give us an extra £20,000.
He changed his mind.
Changed his mind?
And the name is Derek Leonard.
I've heard that name somewhere before. Oh, actually, come to think of it, Cleo, the chap we spoke to was a Mr. Thomas. Yes, Mr. Thomas. I remember because he said, "Don't doubt me." Don't you get it? Doubting Thomas. One of the disciples.
Bernard. This is no time and place for your word games.
These are simple, basic contracts, as you can see. Now, this is where you agree to the sale of Barlow House. This is where you agree to the completion of the sale and agree to the exchange of contracts today. So, it's a simple completion of a deal and exchange of contracts all at the same time. Also, I am aware that the deal with the trustees of Barlow House has been agreed, which will give possession of the property on Christmas Eve.
Derek Leonard, I know that name.
Well, no, I'm sorry. Why should we accept £175,000 when he agreed on £195,000? No, a deal is a deal.
I have in my possession a computer disk. This is the record of all the money that you have fraudulently claimed over the last 10 years. Mr. Leonard will forward this to the relevant authorities and the trustees of Barlow House if you don't sign.
I don't believe you. You're bluffing.
Does the Baroness file say anything to you?
That's blackmail. You can't do that.
I don't believe it. I knew we'd get caught.
Oh, shut it! How the hell did you get hold of it?
Could mean up to 7 years in jail, I believe. Are we ready to sign?
Well, we want to count it first, and I want the disc.
Oh, yes, please do, by all means.
I'd love to meet this Mr. Leonard.
Oh, you will, Mrs. Baron. He told me to give you a message. It's everyone has three characters. One is that which they exhibit to other people. Two is that which they have. And the third is that which they think they have. He said you'd understand.
Where do I sign?
I can't believe it'll soon be Christmas. This is a glorious October. Everything has been completed to your satisfaction, Derek.
Thank you, James.
I trust that I'll see you again.
I'm sure we will. Because of life's rocky path, but next time perhaps on ground that doesn't hurt our feet.
I'm not entirely sure that I understand you, Derek, but cinch it and keep up the good work. Oh, by the way, you've sold another publishing deal. In Australia, I believe.
You can go now, James, but say hello to Barbara for me. Thank you very much.
What's all this about selling another publishing deal in Australia? What the bloody hell does that mean?
Have you seen the film Misery? You know, the one where the bloke gets tied to a bed and then she breaks his feet with a hammer and a block of wood?
Yes, I have.
Well, that's on telly tonight.
Come on, up you get. Yeah.
Whoops! Come on. Excuse me, I see Mr. Baron.
I think that's your car there. Get in it and don't come back.
Get out of the way, you moron!
I think you better leave, David, because you see, your deal's just not going to happen. Now, do remember to be nice to everyone you meet because we're all fighting a very hard battle.
And if you want to keep your limbs attached to your body, take your car and leave.
Are you selling? What are you selling? This is a home for care in the community, for people who are trying to get back on their feet.
And bye!
Bye! There are people who, and people who come here to get well, and they're trying to get back into the community. And there are people here who are putting on things and they're not trying to get well at all because they like having a free accommodation and the free food. And I've been here for 10 years and I'm the oldest resident here and you should be dealing with me, not with anybody else.
Can you believe it, Derek? It's almost a year since you moved in. Doesn't time fly?
It certainly does, Rachel. Do you know, I never used to like Christmas as a child, but this year,
I'm really looking forward to it.
What do you like for Christmas, Derek? Not off me, but... Say you could have anything in the world. What would you have?
Well, they say that those that are good in health are rich in life, aren't they? I think I'd just like to keep my mind clear and, I don't know, stay generally healthy. What about you, Rachel?
Well, I agree. Without health, what's it all about?
What's all this then? Who's having a Christmas party?
Looks like we are, Bazza.
I think it's Bernard's idea of a little going away drink.
What have you got in here, eh? What's going on with Derek?
Listen, I don't say nothing to nobody. I don't know anything anyway. And what makes you think that anyone can fight in an Irishman? Everyone around here treats me like I'm a bloody garden gnome, as if we're tick or something. Here, get a grip of these. Give me a lift. Come on.
Oh, you've nearly finished.
I have.
Oh, go on, go on, carry on.
Can we get some
time? When you finish,
over here.
That's it, over here.
Come on, just have everybody's attention, please. Thank you. You've all got Christmas drinks, jolly good. Bernard would like to say a few words.
I'll try and make this as brief as possible.
Well, you care to look at these,
just to say goodbye
to the house.
I know the sale of the house means you all have to be relocated, and I regret this, but I had to make a choice. I needed to sell the house in order to retire. A little early, I admit, but as the blessed Margaret always used to say,
I think we've heard quite enough of that now, Bernard. Thank you very much. So please stop droning on if you don't mind. Ladies and gentlemen,
really?
I'd just like to announce that I am the new owner of Barlow House.
What did he say?
Even though I've been very ill, managed to put away a few pounds. Yes, Billy?
Correct.
You know what they say? People who want nothing from you except friendship are both very rare and hard to find.
Oh,
cheers.
Not fucking drivel. I don't believe you. Let me have a look.
It's all there. There's a deed.
What's the name? Yes. Out.
Oh!
Out.
This is appalling!
Out.
Double-crossed us. How dare you treat us?
Out.
I'm surprised
at
you.
Out.
I thought you had more sense and more decency.
Out.
Get off me! How dare you?
Out.
I'm surprised
at you. I didn't farewell big to you, darling.
Bye. Cheers, everybody.
Are you listening in the land? So is glistening. It's a beautiful sight. What happened tonight?
Oh. Good evening, officers. Cleo!
What's going on?
It's these two officers.
What are you
Baron.
Talking about?
I'm arresting you on suspicion of embezzlement.
Is the are you married? We'll say no, ma'am.
You can't do this. We've got a plane to catch.
Looks like you miss your flight.
Go!
Go on, love.
Why, she's ridiculous.
Are you listening in the lane? Snow's glistening, a beautiful sight for a happy tonight. Walking in a winter wonderland, gone away. Is a bluebird here to stay? Is a new bird?
happy. Oh, I've still got a few problems, but that's nothing for you to worry about. This home, my friends, is your home for as long as you need it. And I really mean that. And Billy.
Sorry, yes, sir.
Billy, my friend. I am going to invest in a few more properties, Billy. But I want you to be my business partner in the venture. In fact, Billy, I want you to consider running the home for me. What do you say?
I don't want to let you down, but yeah, when do I start?
And Andy, we've both come a long way. Well, there's a job for you here too, my friend. And I'll get somebody in from the health service to give you some assistance. How's that?
Thanks, Derek. Don't have to say, mate.
Pleasure. Thank you. Nigel, just wait there a minute.
Where's he going?
Dougie, look at his. You're back.
Now, I know your jobs didn't quite work out in Salcombe, my friends. I know it didn't work out for you, but there's a home for you here too for as long as you wish.
I've come a long way, you, Derek. So proud of it.
Thank you. Lazarus?
Yeah.
Dougie? Loudmouth Bazo? And Terry, come here. Are you there? I want you four to pack your bags and go. Huh? Only joking. I'm only joking, Terry. You can put your notebook away.
It was funny, that, Derek.
And Billy, you know when I said wait to see what Father Christmas brings you? There's something else for you, my friend. You just stay there a minute.
You know, where's he gone? Might be a jumper, Billy.
Merry Christmas, Billy.
Happy holidays. Happy love you, Billy.
Love you too. Merry great Christmas.
Yeah.
This man is truly remarkable.
Oh, yes. I spotted him when he first arrived. He is a truly different sort of man. A bit like Jesus, like he was. He has the ability to make people follow him. He also has the ability to heal. Look at the effect he's had on some of those residents here.
Yes.
Don't praise me, Billy. Praise are for those that need it. Warm off again. Sorry about that. Anyway, Rachel, there's a job for you here too, my friend. And I'd like to say, if it wasn't for you, Rachel, well, I wouldn't be here today, because you are truly the best social worker in the world, and I want to thank you.
I'm going nowhere. It's as if our paths were meant to cross.
Well, you know what they say, Rachel? Paths do cross, and sometimes we take this path and we take that path, and it might be a rocky path, and I've lost it. It's the first time I've lost it. Look, all I'm going to say, my friends, welcome to our new home, and God bless you all, and Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
We are home this Christmas. We are home this Christmas time. We are home with the people, the people that we love. It's gonna be a happy night. It's gonna be a nice starshine.
And I love you all.
You're a grand man.
Thank you, Pat.
A grand man.
We are home. We are.
That's your car there. Get in it and don't come back. I think that's your car there. Get in it and don't come back.
I was there, though. It's not your fault.
Seven, take one. Action.
Yes. Sally. You're going to take your hat off before I start the dialogue. Well, let's use some practical examples, shall we? I want a quick sale, and I know how quickly I can deal with this. I want to know how quickly can you deal with all this. I'm sorry I've gone totally blank.
It's fine.
What makes you think that anyone would confide in an Irishman? Everyone around here treats me like I'm a toadstool. Like I'm a stick.
Do be quiet, Bernard. This is no time and place for your word games.
These are simple, basic contracts.
Get some ideas for ourselves.
A bit of chippy research, yeah.
My head's killing me.
Ah, so far.
There's a place in time together we can find all we've left behind in that place in time. Nothing seems to reason in my mind. Places come and go, just like melted snow. No one seems to know what makes a river flow, only to return to a place in time.
Man.
Thank you, Pat.
My grandma.
We are home.